Hello, everybody, and welcome back. This is amazing. I love doing these units here in the Facebook group just for you guys. And today we're going to talk about how to build up your courage and your confidence as you move towards your dreams and your goals. I love this subject. It's one of the main subjects I work on with my clients because, just like myself, at one point I had low confidence and low courage. And I want to show you some of my tips and tricks on how I overcame a lot of those, different kinds of things that held me back, those different kinds of mindsets, and how I was able to push forward and make my dreams a reality. All right, let's get started. Okay. Everybody who knows me knows I love a plan. I love a vision, something that's going to pull me forward towards my dreams and goals. So, one of the key characteristics of a successful entrepreneur is that they know what they want and they're going to go after it. Now, I want you to do this. This is just an exercise. If you haven't already, I want you to write down your plan, your goals, your vision, and what does it look like? If you have that in mind, it's going to help you build up the courage and the confidence you need to move forward with action. The second tip is to model others. There are so many successful people out in the world doing amazing things, and I love being able to learn so much from them. Tony Robbins, Dean Graziosi, Russell Brunson, Lewis Howes, Chalene Johnson, Deepak Chopra, I mean, Dave Asprey, David Goggins, the list goes on and on. I surround myself with these people because they know what they're doing. They've already overcome their obstacles, and now they're sharing with us their, experiences and how they were able to do it. So make sure you go out there, listen to podcasts, read their books, watch their videos, see what they're doing, and pull some of those elements into your own world. Make it happen. And of course, one of my favorite tips is to get coaching and support. Many of you may not know this, but I have been a coach now for over a decade. I started out as a coach for health and fitness. I was a personal trainer, a women's coach, and I did lots of women's groups. So I love coaching. I have, I think, a natural gift for encouragement and support because I know what it's like to be alone. I know what it's like to struggle, and I would hate for anyone to have to go through what I went through in learning to become successful in my life. So I'm a huge advocate of coaching and support. I believe that we all need someone in our corner rooting for us and holding us accountable, helping us cross the finish line, giving us those encouraging words when just when we need them, right? And if you don't have someone in your corner right now, I am here for you. That's actually one of the biggest reasons I created this group, so I could be here for you as your coach, as your encourager, and as your supporter as you move towards your dreams and goals. So if you want more coaching with me, make sure you reach out to me. I am here for you. And you can actually book your call for free today if you'd like. Let's talk. So the next tip I want to give you is if you want to build up your confidence and you want to build up your courage, is that you have to deal with your fear. And everyone has their own fear that they are dealing with, their own fear factor. One way to get over the fear or to get through the fear is to do your research. If there is a subject out there or if there's something you want to do, but you're just not sure on how to do it and it's just you're scared of it, I highly recommend doing research, reading about it, asking questions, joining a seminar, a group, a mastermind on it. Whatever you need to do to get more information, this is going to do two things for you. It's going to lower your fear factor, and it's going to lower the risk. Because a lot of times we have this feeling attached to the fear that we're risking something. We're going to get hurt. Something bad's going to happen. Or there's an uncertainty of something. If you're moving forward on something you're just not sure of. So how do you counteract that? Is you just learn more about it. I'll give you a simple example. I really wanted to go scuba diving down in Punta Cana in the Dominican Republic, and I'm a better swimmer now, but I wasn't a strong swimmer when I wanted to do this. So what did I do? Instead of, opting out, I went ahead and I started doing research. What is scuba diving? I took a class. I took a swim class to increase my skills. And before you know it, my confidence and my courage grew. When I got down to the Dominican Republic, I jumped in the water without any hesitation. I had an amazing experience, even though I got really sick afterwards because I was on the sea for a very long time. Seasickness is horrible, by the way. But the cool thing I noticed, there was another girl next to me who was doing the swimming with us, and she got in the water okay, but she would not go under. And when I came back up for my trip, she looked at me, she said, "Oh my gosh, how did you do that? You did it so easily without any fear." And I said, "Yeah, well, I prepared." I prepared myself. I took classes. I was serious about it. I wanted to make sure I didn't miss out on this amazing experience. And she's like, wow, that's awesome. So don't miss out on an amazing experience. Don't miss out on an amazing business opportunity. You know, make sure you prepare yourself. Make sure you do the research, overcome that fear or push through it and get to the other side because something amazing is waiting for you. Okay, the next tip. I want you to be okay with ugly. And I know this probably sounds completely anti-success, but I'm telling you, the things that I've learned with my marketing and my sales coaching is that sometimes ugly is just a ticket to get someone's attention. A lot of people get caught up in perfection, and I was one of those people. I love having control over my projects. I love it, you know, making it perfect, polished, and ready to go. Well, I've learned very quickly that that's not always the necessary thing to do, because what happens is if we get too caught up in the details, we get too caught up in polishing and perfection, we're going to miss out on opportunities. We're going to miss out on bigger and better things down the road. We're going to miss out on an experience to get even better. So just put something out there. I encourage you just to do it. Right now, if you're just starting out, no one's really paying attention to you. So this is the time to mess up. This is the time to just put something out and test the waters and see what you can do. And then from there, you can start building. That's exactly what I've been doing. In the beginning, if you go back to the beginning of the year, you'll see some of my earlier videos and earlier marketing and earlier graphic design, and it's okay. But I've gotten so much better since then, and guess what? I'm gonna continue to get better. That's the cool thing about being an entrepreneur. You can just test the waters, try something new, experiment. You know, we have the right to change things up. We don't have to be stuck in a cookie cutter kind of business or a cookie cutter kind of mindset, you know, or anything with it, when it's graphic design, social media, whatever you're talking about. So it's okay. I'm giving you permission to be completely you. You know, vulnerable. I want you to be transparent. I want you to be real and authentic and just put it out there. And you can even let people know, you know, just say, hey, give them a little disclaimer, guys. I'm just getting started. I would love your opinion. What do you think about this video? What do you think about this social media post or this photo or this graphic art design or this logo or this ebook that I'm coming out with? So I heard this saying and it's always stuck with me. When I was writing my ebook last year, I was doing some research on how to launch it and get ready for that. And they said that, you know, a lot of writers will get caught up in perfecting their book to the point where they never get it published. So the quote was saying, a published good is better than an unpublished great. So sure, could I make my book super fantastic and super polished and super perfect? Sure, but how long is that gonna take? I'd rather put something out now. Can I always go back and change it up, revamp it, add more chapters, and relaunch? Sure, that's the thing about it. That's the beauty of it. You don't have to be so locked in. People think you have to be locked in. You don't. Have the flexibility that you need to be able just to put something out there. If it's ugly, who cares? Go back later and spruce it up. But please don't let this, you know, get in the way of building up your courage and your confidence to move forward on something you truly want to do. Okay, the next tip, I'm going to encourage you to always say a yes. And just in the beginning, until you get your footing on really who you are, what your brand is all about, but say yes to everything. So for instance, if someone says, hey, Teresa, I want you to be on my podcast. Would you like to come on my podcast? What is the answer? Yes, of course I'll be on your podcast. A lot of people, again, will get stuck in the fear of it. They've never done a podcast. They don't know how to interview. They've never really been great at public speaking. What are they going to talk about? Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. Like, no, we got to stop that. Stop that story right there. When you say yes, your heart's going to flutter a little bit. You're going to get a little excited, a little anxious. That's normal and that's okay. I want you to do it anyway. There is something really beautiful in being imperfect. And remember, perfect is an illusion. I just did a podcast on this, so check it out, Girl's Guide to Greatness. So perfect is just an illusion. You are perfect just the way you are right here and now. If you stumble over your words, who cares? There is a beauty in that. There is a realism in that. People want you to be real and raw and authentic. Who cares about prettying it up? Actually, you know, nowadays people are kind of against being pretty all the time because it's kind of fake. It's like, is that real? Is she this genuine? Is she this, you know, beautiful all the time? Or is she this happy all the time or high energy all the time? It's okay to not be perfect all the time. So don't get caught up in all the things that you could go, you know, that could go wrong or that you cannot do, you've never done before. If you were asked to do this podcast and you said yes, and that's what I'm hoping what you said is yes, get prepared for it. Just say, hey, you know, give me a couple of weeks to prepare. Then get with someone to help you prepare for it. Practice what you're going to say. Do some research. Remember going back to what we talked about before, lowering that risk factor and lowering that fear factor, because you don't want to cut yourself off from opportunity. You don't want to look back with regret. Okay. So in every time that you move forward, even if it's a small little inch, even if you don't know what the hell you're doing and you're just learning to swim along the way, that is the craziest, awesomest thing you could do, because you're going to become a better swimmer. You're going to get stronger. You're going to get wiser, more experience. And before you know it, months later, and so this is going to happen pretty quickly if you practice all the time, sooner or later, you're going to wake up and you're going to feel even more confident and more courageous. Isn't that amazing? And that brings me to my next tip. When you start feeling courageous and confident more than you did than yesterday, this is great news. This means that you can now go out into the world and help coach someone else. Share your experiences, share your enthusiasm with someone else and get someone else excited. Share what you've learned with them so now they can go out and do great things. Ah, and here's the next tip here. I absolutely love this one, and I actually incorporate this in almost everything that I do. My podcast, my training modules, my training videos, my presentations, I always include prayer and meditation and affirmation. It is big, because programming your mind into success and programming your mind into winning is the key to getting what you really want out of life. So if you really want to be more confident and more courageous, you've got to pray for it. God, make me more courageous. Give me courage. Go before me and show me the path that I should take. Show me favor. You know, so pray for it and then reaffirm it. Speak it out loud. When I'm in my car, when I had a car back in Texas and back in North Carolina, I would actually, in my car, say, I am courageous. I am confident. God has made me a special, talented, amazing, a freaking rock star. Okay? That's the story that plays in my head. That's the story that needs to play in your head. You are amazing. You're freaking fantastic. You are full of magic and power. You are confident and courageous. And last but not least, I want to talk about state. Tony Robbins talks about state a lot with his training programs. It's one of the biggest lessons that I've learned. Changing your state, your physiology, actually moving. The way we move actually tells our brain something. So if you're slumped down and looking at the ground, your brain is thinking sad, depressed, insecure. If you straighten up with your shoulders back, yeah, a little swag, right? Your brain starts to say, you saw my smile, right? I changed. And my brain says, ah, she's courageous. She's confident. She's a freaking rock star. Okay, so make sure you change your physiology. If you see yourself every once in a while kind of getting back into those old habits of, you know, being down on yourself, insecure, fearful, just make sure you kind of straighten up. Again, bringing those affirmations in at the same time would even be more powerful. Yeah, you can't touch me. I'm amazing. You know, God's got me. Nobody can come against me. You start doing that so often, it's going to be embedded into your DNA, guys, at a cellular level, at a spiritual level, and nobody can touch you. You will become unstoppable, believe me. So I hope that I inspired you a little bit and encouraged you to keep moving towards your dreams. Keep building up your courage and your confidence. I am here for you and I'm supporting you the whole way. I can't wait to see you on the next module. Until then, continue being a freaking rock star.